The following story has been brought to you by StoriesToInspire.org.
The Chofetz Chaim in his Sefer Shem Oilam in Perek Ches in Hagah recounts the following story. And the Chofetz Chaim says, this story, Be'enai Ro'isi, I saw with my own eyes. There was somebody who had a number of children over the years, and each child died in infancy, Rechmana Litzlan, passed away. And this person came to a Chacham Echad, to a certain Chacham. And he asked this Chacham, what can I do as a skula that I should be zeicha to have children that will live, will be a Zeresh El Kayama? Now, the Chofetz Chaim writes that I saw this story, Be'enai Ra'isi, the entire story, and he writes every single detail. I think it's pretty obvious that this Chacham Echad in the story is the Chofetz Chaim himself, but he doesn't write that. And the Chofetz Chaim continues that this Chacham Echad told this person that since the greatest skula for every type of bracha is the mitzvah of Gemilas Chasadim, I would suggest to you to make a gemach that lends money. There is no gemach in this town. I would suggest to you that you make a gemach to lend out money, and in that schus, you'll be zeichet to have children that will live. That's what the Chofetz Chaim says. He saw with his own eyes what this Chacham Echad told this person. He said the person went and wrote up a whole, took a pinkus. That pinkus means like he took a little notebook and made rules. He spent a lot of time making a gemach with rules, how much money to lend out, how when it has to be paid back, and he made a whole thing like all these files about how the gemach's going to run. A rule book. And then the person wrote that once every 3 years, when we get to the parasha from Kesef Talva, the mitzvah of lending money, once every 3 years, we're going to make a suda for the people involved in running the gemach, and we're going to, like, you know, discuss about the great mitzvah that we have about running a gemach. And he wrote in this pinkus, in this notebook, when it's going to come out in 3 years from now, that we're going to make the first suda about commemorating the whole thing about being mechazik, like a suda's mitzvah, being mechazik, the inyan of the gemach. The Chofetz Chaim says that 3 years later, he had a little boy born. And he says just that Hashem wanted to show everybody that this boy that was going to be a healthy boy was being born in the schus of the mitzvah of running this gemilas chasadim, running this gemach. HaKadosh Baruch Hu made that the birth of the baby, and then on the eighth day, the bris milah came out exactly that on the day that it was written up 3 years before, that they're going to make the special suda after 3 years, commemorating a special suda's mitzvah for a chizuk of the gemach. He says the bris milah came out on that day, and everybody was in awe. The Kli Mamesh Hashem is showing that the bris milah came out together with the suda of the gemach that was written 3 years before. You can't get like a better, a more hashgacha pratus than that. And then Baruch Hashem, after that, he had a number of children, the Chofetz Chaim writes. The story's not over yet. He had a number of children, healthy children, and everything was fine. After a number of years, it became very, the gemach grew and became very difficult managing the whole gemach. He says, you know, I did enough years. So he says, this person, the father now of all these children, came back to this Chacham Echad. And he told this Chacham Echad that, you know, I did it for so many years, it's really too difficult. I want to, like, find a replacement. So the Chacham Echad said, no, you're doing such an unbelievable job. I think you're irreplaceable. And this went back and forth a few times. And finally, this Chacham Echad told him, I see that, you know, you really want to give it over. Okay, we'll have to find a replacement then. And they went ahead and they got a replacement. And the Chofetz Chaim writes, Be'enai Ra'isi, that the person went home that night after they found the replacement, and he gave up. He relinquished being in charge of the gemach. He went home at night after Tzeis HaKachavim, after nightfall. The next morning, he was back by the Chacham Echad. And he said, Rachmana Litzlan, you know what happened to me last night? One of my sons choked to death. Rachmana Litzlan. I have so many other healthy children now. I'm taking back the gemach. So the Chofetz Chaim says, what do we see from this story? Exactly what we spoke out in the last chair. that story that I said over about the money with the rent. Zok the Chofetz Chaim, you see from here that a schos ha-chesed, a person can say, but I did chesed for so many years. I did my duties. The Chofetz Chaim says that you know what it's like, he says, doing chesed? He says, imagine someone's going over a bridge. What's under the bridge? A huge ocean, a huge river. And you're going on a bridge. What stops you from falling in? Because you have special, strong beams, whatever they are, supporting the bridge. Zok the Chofetz Chaim, Rachman al-Tzlan, there are mekatrigim on a person. There are Rachman al-Tzlan, a person does have vavers. There are mekatrigim. The water is waiting to come get him. Zok, there he's on a bridge. You know what's holding him up, Zok the Chofetz Chaim? The chesed. That's what the Chofetz Chaim writes in the Sagot. That's what you see, he said. The chesed is that support on the bridge. And the day you stop, he says, the mekatrigim are still there. You take away the beams of support, Rachman al-Tzlan could fall right into the mekatrigim, right into the water. He says, the day, the very day that the person stopped running the gemach, on that very night, Rachman al-Tzlan, he lost one of his children. And he says, and Baruch Hashem, he came back, he took back over the gemach, and his children lived. All the other children live to be Zeres Shel Kayama. But this is the point we have to take, and the Chofetz Chaim adds on. I just have to say one more thing. The Chofetz Chaim adds on and says, I couldn't believe when I saw it. He tells too, he says, and this is not just a story, he says, it's an open pasuk. And then the Chofetz Chaim says, well, we said over in the last podcast, that you see in Perek Dalet and Daniel, that when Daniel told Nebuchadnezzar to save himself through Tzedakah on the very day, the Medrash says, on the very day that Nebuchadnezzar stopped giving the Tzedakah, on that very day, he lost his mind. On that very day, so we see the Chofetz Chaim. Chofetz Chaim tells us too, I couldn't believe it. He tells us to Oven and Pasek that we need chesed. The second we stop the chesed, Rachman al-Tzlan, we lose that power. We lose the beams holding up the bridge. We need it, keseder. May we always be zeicha to constantly do chesed, and may we always be zeicha to be on the receiving end of constant chesed from HaKadosh Baruch.
You've just experienced...
Enjoyed this story? Come again. Bring a friend. StoriesToInspire.org